Good evening. We welcome you to Frederick P. Rose Hall. This is the House of Swing. It's the home of jazz in Lincoln Center, and we're happy to have you in our home this evening. We've got a special program. Tonight we celebrate one of our own, a man that we all love dearly, the one, the only, Joe Temperley. Now please join me in welcoming to the Rose Theater stage the Jazz and Lincoln Center Orchestra with Wynton Marsalis.
Joe has been the anchor and foundation of our orchestra, and the depth of love we have for him can't be expressed. Respect, veneration, and we're honored to present this concert. So of course the saxophone section had to take it over because he belongs to them, and different members of the section, they've all written arrangements of songs that Joe requested, and they're going to speak on it. Chris Crenshaw will represent the trombone section with one of his pieces, and I will represent our trumpet section. The rhythm section is always represented because they never stop playing. I'd like to open Victor Goins' arrangement is going to be first, and he will speak about it, but first, let's please welcome Mr. Joe Temperley.
Thank you all very much, and welcome. I know we have a lot of people in the house who are regulars, but I want to tell all our young folks who are out there, you are about to witness an experience that is like no other by hearing this great man play. So many of us talk about the things that we've missed in our lives, missing here in Duke Ellington, or this player or that player. Well, you in the House of Swing tonight, you're going to get to hear Joe Temperley play. This is going to be something unforgettable. And if you're as lucky as we are, you'll be able to tell somebody 50 and 60 years from now, you heard Joe Temperley play. One thing that I have recognized from being in a band for 22 years, and Joe has been in the band the entire time, is that he is a man who is truly dedicated and committed to the art form and to his people. Each night we worked on the road, we've done thousands of concerts all over the world. He has always been the first person there to warm up, prepare for the gig, and most time he's the last one to leave at the end of the night. And it's just remarkable to witness that kind of dedication to anything, not to mention to music. And that same dedication he carries in his music is what he carries on in his relationship to each and every one of us on the bandstand and to all of the people who come from all over the world to actually witness him join us with the band to celebrate the music that we love so much. So my gift to Joe tonight in this celebration is a piece that he requested, composed by the great Duke Ellington, and this is entitled Creole Love Call.
I'm going to turn over a new leaf and be late. keep everybody waiting, that's all.
Thank you. Joe Temperley. Victor Goins, arrangement. Paul Nedzella, bass clarinet. Vincent Gardner, trombone. Marcus Printer, trumpet. This is Ted Nash.
Thank you. It's so great for all of us to be able to celebrate this great man and this great musician. I first had the opportunity to meet and play with Joe in 1979. And I was still a teenager. Joe was probably just a little younger than I am now. And we were playing with the National Jazz Ensemble, which was led by a great bass player and composer named Chuck Israels. And we were playing a Duke Ellington piece, and I was playing lead alto. And I was playing with that kind of teenage vibe, you know, energy. And Joe stopped and just said, "This is Duke Ellington. This is not rock and roll." But I didn't need to hear his words. Just sitting in the section with him and hearing his spirit and his soul and the way he approached music taught me so much over the years with that band and, of course, with this band. Over these years, I've seen Joe in so many situations, and he's never, ever represented him to be anything else musically and personally other than exactly who he is. And I love him dearly, and I just feel very, very, very proud to be a friend of his and a colleague on the bandstand. So thank you, Joe. I did an arrangement for him. This is a beautiful Harold Arlen standard that he loves to play. So I did this arrangement. This is "This Time the Dream's on Me."
Ted Nash, arrangement. Joe Temperley. Dan Nimmer. This is Chris Crenshaw.
Thank you. When I say about Joe Temperley, I mean, Joe Temperley, his sound, first of all, I mean, that's the first thing that a person hears when they hear music is the sound. And when I heard Joe play Sophisticated Lady, it was back in 1998 when I got into jazz, I was captivated by the sound and it stuck with me for a long time. I mean, I was fortunate enough to play Duke Ellington's music in high school, college, post-grad, and here in this orchestra, and the sound always stuck with me. And so one thing I can truly say is that just like all the other members of the orchestra, I mean, everyone has their own voice, and that's something that I look for in this orchestra. And Joe, I can truly say, is a one of a kind, down from his voice to the personality, the energy that he brings. I mean, as he goes, we go. And that's always true. Even on the road, as he goes, we go. Yeah. And I can pretty much say that voice, that sound will never be matched, and it shouldn't be matched. You know, this is just a one of a kind. And I use that to my advantage, as we all do when we arrange. In this particular piece I wrote back in 2012, God's Trombones, with James Weldon Johnson. It's entitled Noah Built the Ark. It's the fourth movement of my piece. And amongst all the characters in the in this particular piece, it's broken up into two sections. There's Adam and Eve committing the first sin, and there's the story of Noah building the ark, only to be laughed at by the fellow townsmen, and then the storm comes, and I'll let you use your imagination to figure out who is who. And playing Joe's part this time will be one of his former students, Mr. Paul Netzella, on baritone saxophone. Thanks. Thank you.
Chris Crenshaw, composition. Paul Nedzella, baritone saxophone. Sherman Irby. Ryan Kaiser. Ali Jackson. This is Walter Blandy.
Joe, I'm tired of saying so many wonderful things about you like I did the last two nights, so I'm going to tell you the things that are real drag. One of the things about you that is so pure, it's almost sickening, is that you are totally unpretentious and uncompromising, and you have such an incredible sense of integrity. I admire that very much about you. I remember a couple of things, like, for example, when we played Big Train, and we played a quiet part of the piece, and we laugh about it all the time, and Winton had written a composition that the music was about that thick, and Joe's music fell. Do you remember that? And it made this fluttering sound like all the pages hit the floor, and you shouted out something that I can't repeat, but we laughed so hard. But that's just an example. I guess I'm really trying to say is that you are truly yourself, and you hold back nothing, and I love that about you. It's beautiful. No, really, seriously. Yeah. So, on that note, we're going to play this composition that you requested, and it's called Trichotism by Oscar Peterson. Oscar Pettiford, excuse me. That's a big mistake. Oscar Pettiford, the bass player, not Oscar Peterson, the pianist.
Thank you.
Of the Blanding arrangement. Joe Temperley. Carlos Enriquez.
Sherman Irby.
Anytime we compose a new work, whether it's an arrangement or something for an old standard, we always think of Joe Temperley. That shows the power of his presence, of his sound, of just his very being. When I was commissioned to compose a new work for the orchestra, I decided to write a ballet based on Dante's Inferno. Of course, I thought of Joe. He played the role of Dante. Now, he, like most of us, knows what it means to go through hell and come out of it with faith, hope, and optimism. This is the last movement of the ballet entitled Inferno. It's entitled The Shores of Mount Purgatory.
Sherman Irby. Joe Temperley.
Now we'd like to conclude this first half with all of the saxophone players getting their big horns out. Sherman is going to break it down.
When we think of the name Joe Temperley, we always think of the baritone saxophone and the bass clarinet. For many years, you may not have known, but he actually made his mark as a tenor saxophonist. Now, in honor of Joe, we wanted to play a song that featured five baritone saxophones playing the melody and everything. Unfortunately, the spirit was willing, but the pen was weak. This is a piece arranged for one tenor saxophone and four baritone saxophones, even though I think Vic is going to throw a little baritone in there for us, too. This is Eddie Lockjaw Davis and George DeViviers' classic, Very Saxy.
That's right.
For Joe Temperley. We're the Jazz at Lincoln Center Orchestra. We're gonna take a little break and be back in 15 minutes to celebrate Joe some more. Thank you very, very much.